You may remember Lauren Duca, a writer for something called Teen Vogue. She came on the show once in December. I was a little snappy with her. She's been milking that appearance ever since. In subsequent months, no kidding, she's been the subject of a fawning New York Times profile. She gave a college commencement address and in general became a lot more famous than her talent would suggest is possible. Well, today, true story, Hillary Clinton herself sent a personal letter to Duca praising her, quote, excellent work for Teen Vogue, along with her courage and poise. We're quoting now. The internet is not a friendly place for women, Clinton's note says, especially those who aren't afraid to speak their minds and challenge established systems of power. Now, Hillary Clinton's from a different generation, so we'll give her the benefit of the doubt and assume she's never been on the internet before. Otherwise, how could she write that? Unfriendly to women? Are you kidding? The internet is unfriendly to everybody. Trust us. That's what happens when people get to comment anonymously. They're very unfriendly. And no one on the internet is less friendly than Lauren Duca, irony of ironies, who recently sent a tweet imagining Donald Trump dying in a plane crash and told someone else online to, quote, die in a fire. To Hillary, that's challenging established systems of power. But the most remarkable thing about Lauren Duca is that for a writer, she can barely write. And that's a problem, even for someone paid to produce frothy political propaganda for a kid's magazine. We need to, quote, stop Donald Trump from threatening the sovereignty of an entire religion, she wrote at one point, without bothering to explain how it's possible to threaten a religion's sovereignty. She began another piece this way, quote, the White House vortex of scandal has ratcheted to new heights. Ratcheting a vortex to new heights? Never in the history of language have metaphors been treated so poorly. The frustrating thing is here, there are impressive liberals out there, ones who can think and write clearly, who've got interesting things to say. Lauren Duca is not one of them, but Hillary loves her because she thinks Duca is a victim. And Hillary's not the only one. Every time we mention Duca on the show, she gets more and more famous and more revered on the left. Maybe next week she'll be honored by the Pope and the Dalai Lama. If we mock that, she could get the Nobel Prize for Literature. 15 years from now, we could be making fun of President Lauren Duca, assuming that is still legal by then, so we'd better stop. We're making it worse. Our apologies. On a JetBlue flight yesterday, the man, who was a lawyer from Brooklyn, berated her about her father before being kicked off the flight for disorderly conduct. Even a lot of liberals thought his behavior went way too far, but not all of them thought that. Some of them thought it was justified, and that would include our next guest. She's Lauren Duca. She's a journalist, and she tweeted this earlier today. Ivanka Trump is poised to become the most powerful woman in the world. Don't let her off the hook just because she looks like she smells good. Lauren Duca joins us. Now, Lauren, thanks for coming on.
Hi. Thanks for having me.
So I think, of course, it goes without saying that it's valid that you disagree with Trump and you have your own set of political views and perhaps you disagree with Ivanka Trump. I wonder, though, screaming at a mom and her kids on an airplane seems like a violation of privacy and decency and good manners, and it raises the question, what are the venues where you shouldn't scream your political views at people? Would a funeral be out of bounds, church, her son's bris? Like, what are the rules on that?
Oh, at a bris. Yeah, well, I think what is a nonpartisan issue is that air travel is horrific, and I don't think anybody should the enduring confrontations in the air, be it Ivanka Trump with her children or just any other human being in a tin can and feeling dehydrated. And I think that the fact that she is with her children is significant. And I do also think that, you know, a mother in public who's a public figure, you know, there are certain levels of decorum that we should be thinking about. At the same time, she does have an incredibly powerful position. And she's not just a mother. She is a powerful, powerful woman who's connected very closely to the president-elect, not just as his daughter, but in many ways as a business confidant and advisor. And I think that we haven't quite been able to define what all those roles mean. So while I don't, you know, I don't want anyone being yelled at on a plane. I don't want anyone yelling at me on a plane. I don't want to yell at anyone on a plane. But I think that, you know, Ivanka's incredibly compelling brand and presence and role as a mother and successful woman, those are interesting and attractive elements of her brand, but I don't know that, you know, where do those protections end too? Kind of would ask you the same question as the funeral breast.
But wait a second, that's not at all what your tweet suggested. In addition to the one that we just read, you put, I think we can put it on the screen.
My tweet didn't talk about the plane at all, actually. So what are you referring to?
Well, it was within the, look, Ivanka Trump was in the news about because she was screamed at on the airplane, and you say, don't let her off the hook. And then you go on to say in another tweet, Ivanka has it all, and by that I mean a job, a family, and sinister complicity in aiding the most aggressively anti-woman candidate of our time.
Yes.
Sinister complicity. She's his daughter. What is that?
She was a surrogate frequently throughout, represented him in terms of women's issues. She had repeated interviews, and she did speeches on his behalf where she represented a platform of women's empowerment. And in terms of having it all, I think she's an incredibly successful, brilliant woman. The fact that she was able to balance him out on these issues where he has talked about defending Planned Parenthood and being against abortion and these typically liberal women's issues that she sort of is a cushion for, I think we need to investigate those things a little more critically, a little more rigorously, and not be blinded by the fact that she looks like she smells like vanilla.
Okay, she looks like she smells like vanilla. I mean, who's objectifying women here? I wouldn't say that.
Oh, my God.
No, I'm actually asking a serious question.
My point is she's a beautiful, gorgeous force of nature.
I don't care what she looks like or smells like. I mean, what exactly do you disagree with her on specifically?
Oh, my goodness. I'm saying that she is incredibly welcoming. She is gorgeous and smart. I mean, she's in a lot of ways, many elements of her persona are... admirable and something to look up to is what, it, you know, is a joke.
Okay, but you said that she is sinister, she has sinister complicity in aiding the most...
Yes, I absolutely believe that.
Okay,
I'm not backing down from that at all.
So it's sinister for a daughter to support her father's presidential campaign because you don't like her father?
It's sinister for a daughter to capitalize on the power of feminism and uniting women and empowering women while supporting a candidate who is the most anti-woman candidate this country has seen in decades.
What does that even mean? Like, why don't you tell... I mean, what is he's anti... What, she's anti-woman because he wants to... defund Planned Parenthood.
I'm sorry, is that what I said? I think my earpiece might not be working because that is most certainly not what I said.
Okay. She's guilty because he's anti-woman. She's complicit in his, quote, anti-woman positions.
To continue to stump and support his positions.
But it's her dad. I mean, I don't understand. So I guess the point I'm making is you're drawing this kind of world where everyone who's not on your side is evil and
that's
is,
not what
as
I
you
said,
put
even
it,
remotely.
Fair game.
That's
well, actually,
not what
it is what
said.
You said.
Tucker,
you said she's,
Tucker,
quote, fair game, even though she smells good.
Tucker, I did not say anybody who disagrees with me is evil.
Then I'm going to ask you again. What do you disagree with that she has said? What position that she holds do you disagree with?
I disagree with her providing a surrogacy for her father based on an empowerment of women when that is an inherent disconnect between his campaign and her beliefs.
You agree with her, but because she supported her dad, she's somehow fair game.
I did not say I precisely align with her.
I'm trying to understand what you're saying.
You're not,
what that she believes, don't you believe?
Tucker, you're not trying to agree with what I'm saying. You're shouting over me every time I speak. It's incredibly unprofessional.
I'm asking you a simple question.
You're not.
Which is,
you're actually being a partisan hack who is just attacking me ad nauseum and not even allowing me to speak.
Well,
Tucker, I think we agree here, right?
No, I don't think we do.
We both agree that she didn't deserve to be attacked.
I think it's appalling that some guy yelled at her on an airplane and you're saying she's, quote, fair game.
I very clearly and calmly said that no one deserves to be yelled at on a plane. I don't want to yell at you on a plane. I'll yell on you here, but
you're saying that to me because I'm confronting you about it, but on Twitter, on your Twitter feed where you scream, F you, Donald Trump, eat feces, Donald Trump, all this kind of...
Wait, what?
I can't say the word you used, as you well know. But
feces Donald Trump. That's what I said.
You said eat, in effect, human feces on Twitter.
Tucker, you are talking at this trivial, mundane level of argument.
Okay.
We're agreeing.
Tucker, can
I ask you a question? Tucker, can
I
please?
Let me ask you
do you not agree that we deserve, as the American people, a level of transparency in terms of Ivanka's role? I think we need to take her seriously and that she's a positive role model admirable in a lot of ways, but that she still requires transparency.
She's flying with her kids on
she
an
represents
airplane.
In terms of having a government position. Or being a businesswoman, or being a mother.
Okay.
So we do agree.
I agree that anyone who's making decisions about how the federal government runs should have to answer questions about those decisions. Okay. I don't think you should hassle people because you disagree with them in public.
And
period.
I didn't say you should. So we do. We agree.
Here is your description of the Trump administration. You wrote this piece in Teen Vogue, which I guess you write for.
Oh, which I write for? Yes, that's not fake news. That's real news. I write for, you guess? Oh, you guess, Tucker? You guess? That's really patronizing.
I haven't read Teen Vogue because I'm not a Teen Vogue.
Well, you have in front of your producers asked me if I wrote for Teen Vogue. You have my Teen Vogue article in front of you. My name is Lauren Duca, and I write for Teen Vogue.
Well, got it. Here's what she wrote.
Okay.
The road ahead is a treacherous one. There are unprecedented amounts of ugliness to untangle, from deciding whether our president can be an admitted sexual predator to figuring out how to stop him from threatening the sovereignty of an entire religion.
Yes.
What does it mean to threaten the sovereignty of religion? What does that even mean?
That means an entire agenda, a platform of based on banning Muslims, which is still available on his website.
How does that threaten the sovereignty of religion? That's moronic, Lauren. You're a writer. How does that threaten the sovereignty of it? Pardon me for taking your words literally.
Sorry, how does what threaten the sovereignty of it? Threatening to ban Muslims?
That threatens the sovereignty of it?
Yes, that completely, that profiles based on the basis of religion and reduces people to their beliefs and dictates what they can and cannot publicly believe.
That doesn't threaten the sovereignty of it. So you also accused him on Chelsea Handler's show of, quote, committing a form of psychological abuse that makes the victim feel like they're crazy. Does Trump make you feel like you're crazy? That's the impression I'm getting.
Oh, my God. Are you calling me crazy? That's adorable.
I'm asking you said
so
on Chelsea Handler, he's committing psychological abuse on you. You believe that?
On the American people. I believe the American people, Trump supporters, Hillary supporters, Jill Stein and her cousin, are a victim of Trump's gaslighting. What I mean by that is that he frequently contradicts objective evidence, not that he is abusing me personally. And I think you're smart enough to know that, aren't you, Tucker?
I don't know. I just take your words at face value.
He's so did you read the entire article?
Psychological... I did. I also read Liam Payne is 100% certain One Direction will continue. Adriana Grande rocked the most epic thigh-high boots at Jingle Bell, and Blac Chyna and Rob Kardashian went through the messiest breakup of 2016. Those are your other pieces. But I'm trying to get to what you're writing about Trump taking a break from the thigh-high boots and ask what you mean about him committing psychological abuse on you.
Ariana Grande and her thigh-high boots and still
discuss politics. Just letting you know that I read you in Teen Vogue as of today.
And those things are not mutually exclusive. You know, now that you bring up Teen Vogue, we treat young women like they don't have a right to a political conversation.
A bunch of, like, dumb propaganda,
and like you can't be, you know, enjoy Kylie Jenner's Instagram and worry about the future of this country. And those things are not mutually exclusive. So you know what? I did write about Ariana Grande, and I did write about the abusive, bigoted,
deceptive president of the United States. Those pieces were a little smarter than your piece about threatening the sovereignty of a whole religion. All right, I gotta go. You should stick to the thigh-high boots. You're better at that. Lauren, thanks for joining us.
You're a second.